Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to a super quick video to start off the week. So I just got a comment from Jax asking me if I had a video on how I did my title effect on most of my videos, and since I do not have that, I'm going to make that for you right now. And there's a couple of ways we can make this title effect. So first up, let's go up to the effects and go into the titles, and we're just going to take a plain, simple text, and we're going to use that. So the text, which we have the basic of here, is inspired by Pulp Fiction. So this is a how to do a Pulp Fiction inspired title text. So we'll go up to the inspector with the text selected, and I'm just going to put in another text here. Like that, fiction pulp, and I'm going to put this down on the second line. I'm going to make the font larger, and then I'm going to change the font. To do this effect, we are using a font called Auction, which is right here, and we're going to change the color to this yellowish color right here. So now we have the color selection, and then we are going to use, for this example, we're going to use the drop shadow. But we're going to change the color of the drop shadow to red, like that. And then we can simply go into the offset here and move this down a little bit. We're also going to take the blur and take that all the way down. So we're going to get like this heart-shaped background color of red. And then this is the basic of the effect. Of course, we can make a little adjustment by using the stroke. This is just if you really want to. So we can do a red stroke around. And of course, if we bump this all up, it's going to look totally different, but it's going to give you a different, more 3D-like effect. However, if you want to use the stroke, I would use something like one, like that. And here we have the Pulp Fiction effect. So this is the first way you can do this kind of effect using just normal text. We can also use the text plus, and you would think that the process is the same, but it isn't really. So first off, I'm going to put in a text yet again, and I'm going to put the pulp on the other line. I'm going to size it up. I'm going to change the font like I did just before. And I'm going to change the color. And this is where things start to be a little different. So this is the same color I used before. However, when using the text plus, at least in my DaVinci, it doesn't do the same color. It actually looks way different than the color here, but I don't know. It must be something with the software, but of course we can fix stuff like that. If we're going to shading and we go down here to the color, I'm just going to take some of the green out, something like that, and it's a little too dark, so we can bump it up just a little bit, something like that. That is almost the same color, and we can of course toggle this up and down in the colors as well, so we are going to get the exact color we want. However, this is the only way to do it, because you can't hit the right color using the color picker just like you would do in the text node. Okay, for the next thing, again in the shading, I'm going to go to this number 2 here, and I'm going to push enable. So now I'm doing a line around the text. And I'm going to take the thickness and I'm going to bump that up quite a bit. And then I'll go down to the position. And in the position, I'm going to the offset. And I'm just going to push this down just a little bit, something like that. And again, if you want things to change around, you can go into the thickness and make it less. So we have an effect like this. Also, if you are very happy with one of the effects you did, what you can do is, if we go back to our media pool here, and we have our power bins or our smart bins, we can actually just take this and drag this into our smart bins master. If we go into that, we actually have the text plus right here, so we can just reuse this in other videos if we want. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.